We've been trying to coordinate a Pakistan trip after Apostle's initial visit. And every year that we tried, there was always opposition in the development of the trip. Being Pakistan as a very beautiful but volatile nation.
En este viaje específicamente, una de las situaciones más diferentes era el nivel de peligrosidad que implicaba el viaje.
Persecution is something that is part of everyday life to Christians. There are laws that people can be accused of blasphemy, and therefore they could be tried, they could even be executed.
Hacía un mes atrás, más o menos, habían incendiado 35 iglesias y habían incendiado bastantes casas de cristianos.
One of the guys that was part of the team, our security team, they burned his house. So we had to all make a decision to say, I am willing to die for Christ.
And we felt that tension in the spirit. You can't do this unless you're sent. You can't do this unless there's an assignment.
But I saw that you plan to go to Pakistan.
Pero veo que usted tiene planificado ir a Pakistán.
And the Spirit of the Lord said,
y el Espíritu del Señor
tell
dijo,
my apostle,
dile a mi apóstol,
what I will do through him then,
lo que yo haré a través de él,
is beyond his imagination.
I didn't even know that Pakistan was in the books for this year. And I saw that the Lord was going to use him mightily. Before the trip going in, we saw a lot of warfare in regards to the country itself being a Muslim country.
La pregunta que yo me hacía era, ¿quién va a llegar a la conferencia? Y para mi sorpresa, llegó gente con un hambre. Y llegó gente de todas las denominaciones.
I think that's what persecution actually does. Persecution is one of the elements that bring everybody together because our foundation is Christ. And so you see pastors that probably would have never been to another one's conference all gather in one place because of the spiritual reality taking place in the country.
Pakistan, I release on the atmosphere of this nation a mighty revival. I prophesy from the north to the east to the west, that a revival coming upon Pakistan. Are you desperate to see God? Holy Spirit, move. Holy Spirit, move.
There was a hunger. You could see them cry.
Vimos milagros, vimos liberaciones, vimos a Dios moverse, quebrantando corazones, y simplemente fue por encima de lo que yo hubiera esperado. Uno de los milagros que más se dio fue de los sordos oír.
He felt a pop and his ears he could hear.
This lady was deaf in her ear for 40 years. She can hear now.
God created an eardrum.
She is 12 years old. She was born deaf from her left ear. She can hear from her left ear again.
There was a guy that came with a pus in his ear because he was deaf from the right ear since birth.
So this is Sahib. He was deaf from both ears since childhood.
Oh.
He came with pus in his ears. The pus disappeared. He can hear from both ears.
Say, Jesus, heal me.
Yesu ne mujhe shifa diya.
We serve a God of miracles.
A mojizat.
I said we serve a God of
miracles. Be
activated to do miracles. I send you back to your city. Heal the sick. Cast out demons. You have authority. Say, I have authority to preach the gospel, to heal the sick, to cast out demons. Amen.
Can you speak about the bombing that happened? I think it was the first day of the crusade.
Just a developing story. Suicide attack on a security forces convoy killed 9 soldiers and injured 20 others in Pakistan's restive northwest on Thursday.
The whole country was on high alert because these acts of terrorism are not uncommon there.
A suicide bomber targets a political conflict.
No es algo que podía pasar, es algo que pasó justamente en uno de los días que estuvimos en el viaje.
Getting a phone call and receiving a text message stating that, you get a little taken aback. Your humanity comes into play.
So there is no guarantee that says, you know, you're going to go and you're going to come out safely and nothing is going to happen.
The consensus was that we were going to have the event, even if local authorities suggested not to have the event.
The boldness of our apostle gave us all courage to say, if he's bold to do it, might as well just follow through and you know, whatever happens, happens.
Yo creo que una de las cosas que Dios me habló es el hecho de que fuera con una asignación. La asignación que Dios me mandó a Pakistán fue primero para entrenar, enseñar, despertar la iglesia y el pastorado, uno, y dos, recoger la cosecha. Y desde que salimos tenía una misión, Dios me habló. Y si Dios nos habló, Dios nos protegía, Dios nos guardaba, Dios nos cuidaba, y así fue todo el viaje. Pudimos ver gente que llegaba de distancia de 8 horas, 7 horas.
This is a Muslim country. You don't get to gather people like this, you know, out of nowhere.
We're not talking about 10,000 people. We're talking about hundreds of thousands of people.
For me, it's spectacular. This is something historical.
Y yo me atreví, me subí arriba con una osadía para proclamar a Jesús.
Pero cuando el Espíritu Santo lo toma, Él simplemente hace lo que tiene que hacer. Él ya nos lo ha demostrado muchas veces y Dios lo respaldó.
And it had such an impact in the people. It had an impact in miracles and had an impact in salvation.
The doctor found a tumor in her breast, but today the doctor confirmed it that she is healed. The tumor is no longer there.
He was completely blind from the right eye, but God just opened his eyes.
He lost his vision when he was 2 years old. His eyes opened, he can see clearly.
She wasn't able to walk for 9 whole years. Her husband brought her carried with her son. She is now walking and standing as if nothing happened because Jesus healed her.
Say, Father God, I recognize that I am a sinner. I repent of my sin. I believe that Jesus,
Jesus
is the Son of the Living God. Write my name in the Book of Life. I believe with all my heart that Jesus is my Lord. And I believe that God the Father raised Jesus from the dead. If I die today, I will be in heaven.
So the day at the church, again, there's thousands of people, not hundreds of thousands, but there were thousands of people. And there was a time for deliverance, a time for the word, a time for healing, a time for the infilling of the baptism of the Spirit.
Everybody wanted to be touched and prayed for. So, I mean, there was people that grabbed us, literally, you know, that was telling you, hey, remember, put your hand on my head, I need a miracle.
It's like that woman pressing through the crowd to just touch the little garment and be able to receive their miracle, that's the faith that we saw in people.
There's no words, to be honest to you, to explain everything that took place. If we were to go image by image, miracle after miracles, we could write a whole book.
Is there any specific miracle that you remember that really touched your heart, that really impacted you on the trip?
Yo creo que el milagro del niño que se sanó en el hospital mientras me estaba viendo su mamá, eso me tocó muchísimo.
This 3-year-old little girl came with her aunt. She's a registered nurse.
Those are the miracles that prove that God is alive.
The family was in the emergency room 2 days ago, watching us in the conference.
Este testimonio es muy, muy especial porque, número uno, fue a distancia, donde nos muestra que Dios no tiene límites.
The baby was dying. She has lactic acid disease, which means that she cannot drink milk.
Man, I'll tell you the truth. You see those videos and you just feel so much the love of God. You know, you just realize how much God intentionally heals people, you know, at the right time, at the right moment. And at that moment, as a matter of fact, I was praying for other people on the right side, and I literally turned my head to pay attention to the miracle because there was so much commotion.
As they were in the hospital, they took the tubes out of the baby, and the baby began to drink milk. And now the registered nurse aunt brought her to testify that the baby has been better and better, and now is drinking milk on her own.
To get that online was a whole process altogether. But hearing testimonies like that make it worthwhile.
Every time I go to a nation, God always gives me a special miracle. And all the miracles have been awesome. This miracle touched my heart.
Lo que sí sé es que no es normal quitarle la sonda a un bebé que no se alimenta. Entonces, el hecho de que cuando quitan la sonda, el niño empiece a tomar la leche, empiece a tomar contenido lácteo, eso es algo poderoso.
And you see that the Lord intentionally again touches that child to provide for his future, to provide for, you know, the destiny of that child. And so it's something that touches that baby now, but it's actually a work that has been done for the rest of the baby's life. And this, for me, it speaks about destiny, legacy. It's like a whole child being his future restored, his life restored.
This is the reason you send this.
Like when Pastor William told me that going to Pakistan would change my outlook on my Christian faith, he was 100% right.
For me, this whole trip was supernatural. It was heavenly, and we truly experienced the glory of God. From the divine protection to the miracles to you know, the impact on the pastors and the people and the conversions. And it was quite amazing to witness history.
What happened here was not just a local event. This is something to touch the atmosphere of a country. I'm expecting to hear how the hand of God touches that country, even at the point of the world stage.
And I just want to say thank you to my son, Pastor Anchor. Thank you so much for your hard work, for risking your life every single day.
La historia de Pakistán va a empezar a cambiar con una iglesia avivada, una iglesia empoderada, una iglesia que cree que Cristo está vivo y puede demostrar a ese Cristo vivo.